I'm going to show you how to call a range up by using offset values in VBA. In VBA, it's easy to fill a range with values if you know the parameters. For example, if you know it's D4 to D, or to, let's say, T4, and you could just fill that range with values. But if you're basing the range on another cell that you have found, and you need to offset the cells to create the range, I'll show you how to do it. So here's my code. It's called sub offset range, and I've declared a starting position and an endpoint as a range, and I've declared x as long. As a personal thing, I don't try to use I because I'm confusing I with 1 quite often. And so I'm going for x equals 5 to 10, so I'm only going for the middle rows here. And then I have declared a starting position. In my real code, what I was doing is searching for a position to start from based on the day of the week. But so I have declared a starting position here, and this is what I'm going to be offsetting from. And so there I go, start position, start point dot select. And then now to declare a range using offset, what I've done here is I say range active cell offset 0, comma, active cell offset 0, 3, and I'm going to put the value of D in it for day, and then active cell offset 0, 5, so I'm selecting a new active cell here, and then I'm going active cell offset 0, 1, or active cell offset 0, 5 dot value equals E. So now I can use these offsets to enter values in instead of having to specify A4 to Z4. So this works well. So let's run this. So I'm going back to my sheet here, and I'm going to go to the developer tab, and I'm going to macros, and I'm going to say call it offset range, and let's run. And so there you see I have entered all the D's in the necessary places, all the E's in the necessary places, and by using an offset range, and I basically specified that this would be the cell that I'm offsetting from. So that's how you enter values using an offset range. Please subscribe.